Hello, so currently the game has been having a lot of server troubles. Now, if you really want to play the game, you just have to enter the game until it lets you go to the menu, but that should take about 10 to 20 to 50 tries, I don't know. And then just press the login button with your and wait to play with your character. It will be kind of like a blank screen, it will not show anything for about 5 to 10 to 15 minutes, but then wait another 5 to 10 minutes and you can play it. I'm sorry, but this is the only way I can play it, and I'm not really a patient man, so the next step would be to get some kind of a metal, but to get the metal you need to kind of invest a lot of stones in it. Because you have to go to equipment, and then you have the tools, and this is the simple pickaxe. As you can see, you need 10 of these stones, the fragments. But for now, we'll just follow the questline. As you can see, we traveled quite a bit. I also put another sand bed over here. And the quest needs us to kill Rupus, and I'll show you how to kill them very easily and also to loot the urns inside them. So you don't need to go to their village to collect the urns, you just have to find these little shacks over here and enter them, smash them with an axe. By the way, only the axe can smash the urns, not the stick, because the stick doesn't have enough penetration. And there is another urn in the second one. You can enter it just by jumping like that. Now, you can try to use your grapple hook. And it will work most of the times. Now, as a side note, to use the grapple hook, it's a little more complicated than you think. So you have this, you have the show equipment. So if you build your grapple hook, oh, it appears I can't put it back inside my inventory, but you have to put it in this slot, so it's on your character, on his arm, and that's how you equip it. And then I suggest you use it as a side button. Your mouse, if your mouse has side buttons, yeah, it's going to be a lot better. And E to rappel up and Q to go down. Yeah, simple as that. Now, I don't really see any more resources here, so I'll just have to go to that big thing over there, which looks interesting. My plan is to actually go to the Rupu village and actually farm them. And by that I mean kill all of them and get more resources. Because they actually have... Stop that. They have some interesting resources. For example, they drop the wood shafts, the Rupu pelts. They have also the Rupu vines, and sometimes you can find the hides and some other things in their little bases. Eating cactus makes you a little sick, so... Let's be full health, because fighting the Rupu is very, very dangerous in the beginning, and you'll see a lot of people getting killed by the Rupus. And of course you have to upgrade your walker. Here we go. Ah, finally. Now, while you're walking or traveling or whatever, you can just put a little fire on the wood. Put a little fire on the wood. No, put fire. Put wood in the camp to make fire to cook. Okay, that was bad. So, while traveling, you can also make charcoal or ashes. Or if you just put the recipe for the water, you can use it to make some water. I don't know, maybe this will be more important later, but for now, it's kind of silly. But yeah, it can cook on the move. Which is a strange concept. I mean, you can save so much time in this game by just doing some little things here and there. Okay, I'm seeing a lot of Rupus. Yes, but definitely the most important thing is to have your sand bed near your current location. Now, occasionally the game will... I mean, you can destroy the cactuses if you want to make people angry or, you know, deny them resources. Hello, brothers. I have come for you. Yeah, it's okay, let's go away. Now, to kill them, just charge up an attack to the right with your axe. Do you have side problems? And then attack quickly again. That will kill them in two hits. Now, that was a regular Rupu. Now, this one is the... whatever he is, the upgraded version. Then attack quickly again. And again, but he is kind of hard to hit anyway. So at this point you run away because all tactics have failed, negotiations have broken down. the ape has bested you, you're no longer the prime survival species on the planet, and go back with the walk of shame. Now, using a bandage doesn't heal you instantly, as you can see, it's a healing process. So, while you're healing, while you're doing the bandage of shame, just gather some resources. Again, this game is mostly based on you being very, very efficient, so... People will have trouble hitting the scrolls, or the... I don't know, the little big rats, fluffy rats. So aim high, use the high attack to kill it, and then use the high attack to also harvest its skin. Now, remember to use all your stat points, and don't use all your fragments, because you'll need a lot of them, especially to unlock the pickaxe or some other things. Now, while you are healing, I don't know if you can cancel. Oh, you can cancel it with right click. Vampires was killed by Rupu Sentinel. Yeah. Don't be one of those guys. You can chase back the Rupu Menace back to their little huts. Also, I recommend you loot them, because their body will disappear and you'll only have a pile of guts and a skull on the ground. Well, that's sick. So, sometimes you'll just lose your prey. Yeah, so that's how not to do it. So again, aim to the right, hit them, do a fast attack and do another fast attack, because they will tend to parry your first one. This is kind of a problem with the current AI. It's very, very predictable. Well, unless you're being silly and take too many risks, then the apes will definitely beat you. I guess you could invest in a bit of armor, but that's 6 fragments. Also, you have the Rufu fur sandals and some other things. What? Come on, I was reading the menu. Yeah, these guys have much longer weapons, so... The best defense for them... Okay, the best defense against them is to just try to kill them faster. Now let's give up and let's see what happens when you die. Some of your gear will stay intact. Oh, okay, I have to wait a little bit. So la 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 la. Sing a happy song. Everyone respawn, okay. Then let's respawn at this one, because I don't want to use the respawn. You want to dance with me? Again, sorry about the current condition of the game, but like I said, their servers are on fire. It seems like we have a little bug with the sound, but... Doesn't matter, we'll push through it. Again, I just wanted to play some more and make some more videos for the game before, you know... I forget about it or something. Now, let's go back. Actually, let's... Oh, we don't have any more bandages? That's because I don't have any more fiber. Okay, let's just bandage up and then go back to our corpse. Yeah, those sentinels are not to be messed with. To be honest, I think it's just better to run away and attack them later, and you can get the first hit on them, but after that they seem to be very, very hard to heal. Sorry, little monkey in the bushes, I think you're doing some business. See, this time it worked perfectly. I don't know what's up with that ape, maybe it's very, very territorial or it was guarding its home. But it was kind of on the smarter side. Yeah, we have no sound, so you have to delight yourself with the sound of my Dracula voice. Count Dracula voice. Okay, sound is back. I see you. You are the one that killed me. Oh. Oh, it didn't regain all itself back, so that means I killed it very fast. Loot player, come on. Don't call me a player. You can say loot yourself. Okay, now we have a lot of bandages, and again, it's better to just use the bandages to have full health all the time, because it will take a while until you heal. Okay, let's loot the vines. Let's enter and smash their pots. So...
Follow the wind, nomad. It is the breath of your ancestors. It will lead you back to the flotilla.
That was 4 fragments. That's a lot of fragments I just got. So let's see, I have to unlock the firefly. Oh, that's an ape. Oh, that's a player. An ape, a player? I don't know. So let's unlock the firefly wings. They are not discreet, and they make good target practice for the enemy. Sure. Huh. Okay. This will take a while because I have to aim at them. Okay, now we have wings. Now we really look like a weird bug. I guess our objectives will be to just go to the walker.
When the moon eclipses the sun, you will see the energy that nourishes life. It is all that is left of Nibiru.
Yeah, that makes good target practice. Open the world map, okay. Fiber armor ups. Finally, we're getting some armor. So remember, be very cautious when you make that level 20, you'll get a lot of unpleasant stuff. Now, show equipment. As you can see, we have some hand wraps, which are... What? Oh, the world map. Okay, I got it.
The sun burns the land behind us. All living things on Earth must run from it. If you do not understand this reality, you will not make it.
Oh, that was 9 fragments. That's insane. That's an insane amount of fragments that I can use to unlock other useful stuff. By the way, the world map doesn't actually load for me. I don't know, maybe it's a problem I'm having, or it's because the map is way, way, way too big, but the game is kind of divided. I mean, the planet is divided into oases, which you have to move periodically because the sun will fry them up. But the story of the game is very interesting because you have basically ice and sand in different parts of the planet. So I guess you will have to move out of the oasis sooner or later. I don't know why the map doesn't load for me, but I'll just have to do that off camera. But you saw, this is the fastest way to get fragments, to just explore around a bit. Maybe you'll find a chest, maybe you'll find one of the big fragment caches in the Rupu Little Huts. Rupu. Maybe it was part of the quest and the last urn gave me a lot of fragments because of that, I don't know. Now, usually you should be using your walker to get to all these areas, but I just want to explore a little bit. Because that was a lot of hard work, killing all those sentinels, I mean... I guess I lost also all my water from the bottles I'm carrying. Okay, let's smash the barrel. Hey, I got another bottle and 2 more fragments. That's amazing, I got so many fragments. I'm not sure what to unlock. Okay, let's go to our little mobile base. Our little firefly, which is now so obvious that you can practically hit it with stones. Now, I explore that part. I guess you could climb on top of those trees for a better vantage point. Oh, and that's another player over there. Players in this game are kind of rough, so he will probably kill me or I'll probably kill him. So let's not meet other players just yet. What? Where? Okay, the Rupus have respawned, so I guess it's time for me to say goodbye to this area. Okay, so to the right. He will block that. Again, fast attack from the left and another fast attack from the left. Wow, that's a lot of fragments I just got now. So what's the difference? Oh, it's an improvised battle and that's a makeshift battle. Okay, let's throw that away. Let's eat some cactus because it's delicious. Yes, I know it's delicious. You heard my character. He said it was delicious. I guess I could do it like this. So that holds. Wow. Improvised battle is much, much bigger. Sure, I guess I can do it like this because I'll get a lot more of those cactus. It's easy to get cactus, but it's harder to get water. Come on, give me water. Okay, I guess we're full of water. So the improvised battle must be an item that you can unlock much later into the game, because as you can see, this one only holds 5 drops of water. Slot protected on death. Yes, okay, that was a pretty good run over here. So search for areas like this one, even though I'm not in the Rupu village, but I'll go there because I just want to kill a lot of Rupus before I leave the area. I'll probably leave the area when I have all the stuff unlocked. And that's what I recommend to all of you seeing this video and playing the game. Don't leave the first oasis until you unlock most of the things in crafting. Now, what I really wanted to unlock is the armor. So what do we have first? Sandals, sleeves, Rupu 4 armor. Well, I guess that could be useful. I don't know how. Damage mine. I guess it's 22% reduction and minus 1. But it slows me down a little bit. On the other hand, you remember you have some workshops you can build, like the ballistas, the small chests. And the sand. I mean, this is basically base building, so don't forget about that as well. Firebolt. I was actually looking at the equipment. Yeah, you can build what was it called? The fiber working station. Worker shares and armor. Fiber weave. This is how you unlock the fiber weave. This is how you unlock the robot. 25. So, whatever you do, don't be a silly goose and unlock the armor that requires rope without actually unlocking the rope crafting. Oh, that, imagine how silly you would be if you did that. I almost did it myself, so that's how I know. I guess you can use the woodworking station to craft wood shafts. Well, I guess you have a lot more options, but for now let's just build us some basic armor. Fast grappling hoop. Okay, so that will be something that we will need to do. So I guess this is the improvised battle, which costs 1 stone, and whatever, I don't need that right now. So that's 6 and 1. I guess I could unlock them as well. Okay, let's craft ourselves some armor. Sorry for the long wait in the menus, but sometimes I just have to be very careful of what I do. Now, I don't see how much durability they have, so I guess if you get attacked a lot, you will have to use something else or build a new set of armor. Okay, remember you can view your equipment and how you look like. Okay, now we look like a sailor from Sinbad and whatever his name was. Sinbad and his brave sailors traveling around the world, yeah. Now let's see if we can unlock a better weapon. Actually, I'm sure we can unlock a better weapon. The torque battery. I don't need technology, I need larger beating sticks. A javelin that I can throw, raw bone hand axe. Ooh, 20 stones, so that will be a while before I get it. Repair hammer, simple pickaxe. Well, I guess you can use the pickaxe as a weapon because it does piercing damage. Again, soft material, like that would work. But I guess the raw bone is the next thing you want to do because the bones... splinters, I guess you can get them from the Rupu villages. I don't know anything about that yet. I'll have to do more research, and by research I mean kill more little monkeys. Okay, we have everything we needed from this area. Let's move on to the Rupu village area and then I'll build a sand bed next to their village and start massacring the little ones one by one. Boom. Now, this is what I call quality traveling. By the way, you get tired by pedaling because this thing uses mechanical. This is a Fred Flintstone car. So you pedal. Yeah, and you'll get tired if you sprint all the way. So yeah, unless you have Fred Flintstone resistance or stamina, this will be kind of a slow method of sprinting. Okay, we'll see each other after I set up my base and start hunting some Rupus. Bye!